Okay, dear students, how are you everybody? I think you all are well. I am Satun Kumar Rai, English teacher, assistant teacher, English, Doimod High School, Baghat Satun, Baghat. You are welcome to the online class. And we know about 17 months later, our schools all over our country have been opened, and during this long period of time you have got a lot of time, and someone or somebody has been tasked with the study, or someone or somebody have been wasted your time. Okay, dear students, now I will discuss phrases, especially in adjective phrases. We know there are seven kinds of phrases, and that is noun phrase, adjective phrase, adverbial phrase, verb phrase, prepositional phrase, conjunctional phrase, and interjectional phrase. Okay, now we will write down the sentences. Noun phrase. Noun phrase, adjective phrase, verb phrase, prepositional phrase, prepositional phrase, conjunctional phrase, and last one will be interjectional phrase. Okay, dear students, I have written seven phrases on the board. Noun, the first one will be noun phrase, adjective phrase, adversarial phrase, verb phrase, prepositional phrase, conjunctional phrase, and last one will be interjectional phrase. There are seven kinds of phrases. We know very well. Okay, now I will discuss about adjective phrase. Adjective phrase adjective phrase I have written, and now I will discuss the parts of adjective phrase. We know very well adjective phrase works as an adjective of within the sentences works as an adjective. The first one will be he is a man of parts. Now I have written a sentence, he is a man of parts. At first we know very well a man of parts will be idiom phrase. This is an idiom phrase, we know. Side by side, this is an adjective phrase, because we know noun plus preposition plus adjective. Noun, man will be noun, and then the preposition of, and then the adjective part. So noun plus preposition plus adjective, and it will be an adjective phrase. Okay, dear students, here I have written a sentence, he is a man of parts. This is obviously an idiom phrase. This is obviously an idiom phrase, and side by side this is an adjective phrase, because we have got a man of parts is man is noun and the preposition of plus adjective, then it will be an adjective. Okay, and next. I have written a sentence. Fishes swimming in the pond. Fishes swimming in the pond. This is fishes swimming in the pond. This is noun plus present participle. We know present participle participle plus preposition plus object or noun, and then it will be, then it will be an adjective phrase. Dear students, please follow the board. Fishes swimming in the pond. Fishes is noun plus swimming present participle plus in preposition plus noun or objective. Noun or objective can say also. Then it will be an adjective tense. Then it will be an adjective tense. Present participle will be be on plus ing. We know be on plus ing. Works as an adjective. Then it will be present participle. Be on plus ing. It is beyond plus ing. Works as an adjective. And it will be present participle. Okay. Number 3. The car made in Japan. Japan is running away. Running away. I have written a sentence here. The car made in Japan is running away. And at the very beginning, here the car will be a noun plus past participle. Past participle. Noun plus past participle plus preposition, preposition plus object, and then it will be an adjective sense. Adjective sense. Okay, dear students, here I have written a sentence. The car made in Japan is running away. At the very beginning of the sentence, the car is noun, and then made is past participle, then the preposition plus object, and it will be an object as a difference. Okay. It is easy to say, but difficult to do. I have written a sentence here. It is easy to say, but difficult to do. Difficult to do. Here, the last portion of the sentence will be difficult adjective plus infinitive adjective plus infinitive. Difficult to do adjective plus infinitive, then it will be a Adjective. Then it will be an adjective.
Yes.
Then it will be an adjective.
Yes.
Adjective plus infinitive, and then it will be an adjective. And the number five will be then number five. Null and void.
I have written
examples here. We know. In spite of that, it will be an adjective. Adjective. Because adjective plus and or but or what plus adjective. Adjective. And then it will be an adjective. And adjective. Null and void is an idiom phrase. Side by side, it will be an adjective phrase. Because adjective plus and but or plus adjective. Adjective starting and finishing will be an adjective, and the middle portion will be and but or. Then it will be an adjective phrase. Adjective plus and but or plus adjective means adjective phrase. Then our next sentence will be he is a close-fisted man. I have written a sentence here. He is a close-fisted man. A close-fisted man, we know. A close-fisted man, we know. This is an idiom phrase, obviously. Side by side, it will be an adjective phrase. Because a close noun means present participle. Present participle. Participle. Or past participle. Past participle. Noun plus present participle. Present participle or past participle plus noun. Then it will be an adjective. Then it will be an adjective phrase. Adjective phrase. Okay, dear sir, I have written a sentence that he is a close-fisted man. This is an idiom phrase, and in spite of that, it is an adjective phrase. Because close means noun plus present participle or past participle plus noun, and it will be adjective phrase. Okay, dear students, and I'll write down the next sentence. Next sentence. He is good in English. He is good in English. I have written down here a sentence is good in English, good in English or bad in English. This is adjective plus preposition plus object or noun we can say. So that will be an adjective phrase. Okay, dear students, he is good in English. Adjective, good adjective plus preposition in plus object or noun, and it will be an adjective. Okay, dear students, thank you everybody. Best of luck. And next class, we will discuss any other topic of grammar items. Thanks.